I am an audience. Mm. I can only comment on what you've shown me. Mm. My letter was in the form of it was like questions, right? Like I'm only asking you questions from what you are showing me.
By the way, Air India is rarely on time.
Listen, I'm an actor. I say what I've been told to say. Hi, this is Swara Bhaskar, and you're watching me on Bollywood Hungama.
Sanjay Leela Bhansali made Bajirao Mastani, and I personally felt that it had some really progressive elements,
yeah.
Because you have a Bajirao who's willing to have his son's name,
yeah,
after
course.
His wife's religion.
Of course.
So I felt that it was progressive, but the fact is that, and he faced resistance at the point of time, but the movie released, and he just, what some would have said, that he got away. The pressure on him this time around was way too fierce. So you never know that,
yeah,
what the movie they made out to be started out to be, and how it was over a period of time, how they were coerced into just changing their entire
of
graph.
Of course, but see, I'm not an insider of that film, right?
Right.
I am an audience.
Mm.
I can only comment on what you've shown me. Hai na, it's like saying that. I mean, I don't know what's going on in your mind.
Mm.
I don't even mean to. So, my letter was in the form of it was like questions, right? Like I'm only asking you questions from what you are showing me,
right,
and what you are putting out there in the public. Varna to criticism, film criticism ka koi matlab hi nahi. Agar main aapko, aapne meri film ko bura review diya, main phone karke aapko suna dun ki yaar, sorry, don't ask me. Itte pressure mein ye wo ye. Fir aapka koi kaam hi nahi hai. Because once you hear my perspective, of course you'll be like, yaar, I'm sorry. Haan, tumne badi mehnat kari. But that's not the point, right?
By the way, Air India is rarely on time.
Listen, I'm an actor. I say what I've been told to say.
Uber in film advertising was a bit over the top. Okay, so you know what I'm trying to basically say. I have absolutely no issues with what you're writing. What I'm trying to say is that this entire fear that filmmakers have to live in, that they have to present things in a certain perspective.
Yeah.
If they don't do that, they're being asked to just pre-censor and all those things.
That's terrible.
My question primarily is towards that in such a scenario, it definitely becomes difficult for anyone to make a movie. That,
yeah.
How do we make a movie now?
But then we have to fight to change the scenario.
Yeah, so that's
because
something.
Because I think it's amazing in our country where. I mean, I really feel, and this is again something that has been happening for a very long time. So it is not any one party or any one government.
Mm.
I want to understand that, you know, the film industry pays such a heavy entertainment tax.
Yeah.
What are we getting in return?
Mm.
If any vandal can come to the set and burn it, if anybody can come and beat the director, if anybody can sit in a TV studio with talwar and say ki hum naak kaat denge heroine ki aur hum gala kaat denge director ka, then so fir aap wo entertainment tax hatai do fir.
But the fact is that there's so many people within the film industry who are absolutely fine being mute spectators. So the fact is that ultimately the lack of unity and the lack of
it's not a
cohesion.
Lack of unity, Faridun. So, I really feel, you know, I actually don't blame the film industry at all for this, because the thing is that look at how vulnerable we are. Look, everyone knows our names, our addresses, our telephone numbers, where we live, where we're shooting. It's so easy to find out, right? That any crazy person, I mean, it happened to, after all, to Aamir sir and to Shah Rukh sir, right? Shah Rukh sir made that comment about intolerance, and his car was stoned where he was shooting in Gujarat. They had to shoot that song in Morocco, in Rais.
His movie got affected, like Dilwale. The box office fate of that movie was because, you know, it did not release for the first 3 days in certain sectors. Rohit Shetty told me it has not released even today till date.
So then
the box office was affected because
then
of...
Then when you're making the industry and the artists of the industry so vulnerable, is it a surprise that they want to stay safe and stay mute? When you create a society where to be safe means to be silent, people will be silent. Because everyone's not crazy like me. People have lives, families, children, businesses, you know, people have a lot at stake. Even normal life mein, yaar, hum kaun sa hum normal citizen bada roz apni naukri chhod ke protest mein nikal raha hai. Sabko safety chahiye. Sabko, everyone at the end of the day wants a peaceful life. Jao office, khana, matlab kaam khatam karo, ghar aao, khana khao, so jao, TV dekho, so jao.
Right?
Bollywood is no different. So I think that we have to ask ourselves, why is our society making silence the condition for safety.
No, absolutely. That is definitely like a cause of concern. And the fact is that the way things are, so basically this term public sentiment, the way it is being misused, ki public sentiment hai Pakistani artist ko nahi aana chahiye, public sentiment hai Padmavati ke baare mein. If everything is going to be run by the public sentiment, then what is the law of the land doing? So that is, because ultimately if anyone can, Padmavati to 2008 mein matlab serial aaya tha pura 47 episode ka, something like that, on television, no one had a problem at that point of time. So those are things which are definitely like cause of concern as well.
Hi, this is Swara Bhaskar and you're watching me on Bollywood Hungama.